right, we're here at the Bobby Gunn, Glenn Johnson fight. King Gabriel Rosales here, you know, here to support Miguel Cartagena, I think.
Yeah.
You know, you got a fight coming up too in January.
Yeah.
Even though you just fought in October. And
I just fought in October.
You had a cut.
That's how I like it, man. It's good to stay busy. It's cool. Yeah. It's just a cut.
Yeah,
it's
part of the game. I can still see it, though.
It's part of the game. It is what it is. But, yeah, we'll be ready for January 25th against Jamil Charlo. All
right, so you're not worried about opening up on you?
Nah.
All right.
It's not. And if it does, I'll keep fighting. I mean, it's part of the game.
All right. You know, this fight is going to be at 154?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It
seems like as soon as you say that it would be hard to make 154 again, they give you a fight there.
Yeah, but, I mean, it is what it is. I asked for the fight to be at 154 just to get back in the mix. So it was actually, they were actually going to make it a catch weight, but I asked for it to be 154 just to get back in the mix.
You'll get a rating if you win.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, all right, that's good.
Yeah.
So how far along are you in training camp for that now?
Now, I'm already doing like 2 weeks. I got about 6 weeks ahead of me. So we'll have a full 8 weeks of training camp once we're ready to fight.
Yeah. How much you know about Charlo? Hey, Jamel, you're fighting, right?
I really don't know much about him, honestly. But, I mean, I've seen him fight. I was at his fight when he fought Demetrius. I was there. I was ringside at that fight. I was actually bored. I mean, I think
everybody was
They were getting booed a lot.
Yeah.
It was a really boring fight. But he's just the type of guy where you just can't let him. You can't allow yourself to get caught up in that pace. You got to set the pace in that fight.
Right.
I mean.
All right. Well, best luck to you.
Yeah. Right, thanks, man.